is Joanna Short from Augustana College. Today we're going to use measuring worth to show how to find today's value of a commodity from the past. As an example, we'll use the price of a 1909 Model T Ford. This is the same example as I used in Tutorial 1, which you can find on measuringworth.com. A Model T Ford, in particular the Touring model, was priced at $850 in 1909. This doesn't seem like much to us today. That's because prices tend to rise over time. There's been a lot of inflation between 1909 and today. However, earnings were a lot lower back then too, so $850 still could have represented a lot of money back then. The question then is, how much was that? We need a way to convert that $850 to its value today. Commonly, people use the Consumer Price Index, or CPI, to do this conversion. The CPI is a measure of the average cost in urban areas for a basket of consumer goods and services. We can use the CPI to see how much, on average, did consumer prices rise from 1909 to today. We can then apply that increase or inflate the $850 into what it would be in today's prices. In essence, we're finding if we took $850 in 1909 and increased it at the same rate as average inflation, how much would it be today? There are two ways we can use measuring worth to help us with this calculation. First, we can find the annualized growth rate of the CPI from 1909 to 2014, then calculate the total growth of $850 over that time period. The formula looks like this. Here, what we need to find is G, the annualized growth rate of the CPI. Okay, that's going to be on average. How much did the CPI rise, or how much did prices rise each year? And then we need to compound that by the number of years between 1909 and 2014. So this N stands for the number of years. Notice that I'm only going up to 2014, which is as close to today as I can get. Okay, the measuring worth statistics are updated as soon as they are available. And as I speak right now, we can only go up to 2014. So let's go over to measuring worth, and I'll show you where to find G, this annualized growth rate. So here we are on measuringworth.com, and I'm going to go over here to this link for annualized growth rate. When you click on this, you see over here in this box there are a whole host of things where you can calculate the annualized growth rate for any of these statistics for any of these date ranges. So I'm going to choose Consumer Price Index and the years that I want, which are 1909. To 2014. And then we'll click on calculate, and we get our result. The result is 3.18%. This means that the CPI increased on average by 3.18% per year between 1909 and 2014. So let's go back to our formulas. So now I have plugged in 3.18, which in decimal terms is 0.0318, into our formula for the growth rate. And I've also added 105 for N, the number of years that we want to compound that increase in prices. So now you can see if you plug that into your calculator, that since this is 26.8, that means that prices in 2014 are about 26.8 times higher than they were in 1909. So when we multiply that by $850, we get a result of $22,780, something similar to what a basic small car would cost today. Now, a second way to do this calculation is to let Measuring Worth do all the calculating for us. What we're going to do is go back to Measuring Worth, and we're going to use the Measuring Worth's Relative Values US Dollar Calculator. Now that I'm back on measuringworth.com, I'm going to go here and choose this link for relative values US dollar. Now all I need to do is enter my initial year, the initial amount, and the desired year. So for this example, I'll enter 1909 for the initial year. The initial amount is $850, and the desired year is 2014. Then we click on Calculate. Now we get a whole bunch of results, but it's kind of divided up into different areas. So here we see if you want to compare the value of a commodity, of an income or wealth value, or a project. And if you hold your cursor over these, you get a definition. Now we want to focus on these results for a commodity. Okay, commodity is a consumer good or service, like a Model T Ford. Okay, we're not looking for an income or wealth value. We're not looking for a project value. In our next videos, we'll consider what to do if your object of interest is an income or wealth or a project value. So we'll focus just on these results. Now let's go back to our slides so we can look at a table. Now the question is, how do we evaluate these different answers that we get from measuring worth? Here I've produced a table which shows the four main results that we get. This is further developed in tutorial 4 on measuringworth.com if you'd like to read more about this. The first result, called the real price, uses the CPI, and we get nearly the same result as we did when we did some of the calculations ourselves. The other results differ only in that they're using a different deflator, or measure of the increase in prices over time. Thus, they're asking slightly different questions about the value of the Model T. Let's talk about the second result, the real value. The real value comes from using the value of the consumer bundle as our deflator. This is a good alternative to the CPI because the CPI measures only inflation for a fixed basket of goods. Thanks to economic growth, though, we are generally able to consume more over time. The VCV adjusts for both changes in inflation and changes in consumption over time, hence we get something a lot larger. You can think of this as a better reflection of the effect that spending $850 would have had on the average person's budget back then, when people generally consumed much less than they do today. Our third and fourth results here, the labor value, comes from using the unskilled wage or the production worker wage as the deflator. This is better if instead of how much the Model T cost in terms of the goods and services that money could buy, or the effect on the budget, we want to know how much people would have to earn to pay for a Model T. Now, wages have risen faster than prices and consumer budgets. Remember how for the CPI, we saw that it rose on average about 3% a year, while the wage increased about 5% per year. Therefore, we get an even larger estimate for the value of the Model T. You can think of it this way. In 1909, $850 represented about 2 years' wages for a production worker. Given the growth in unskilled and production worker wages over time, that 2 years' wages would now be $94,000 or $150,000. So that is today's equivalent of about 2 years' wages. Finally, the income value, our last result, uses GDP per capita as the deflator. GDP per capita is a broader measure of income, including not just the growth of wages, but also interest, rent, and profits. This would represent how much the average person would have to earn from all sources today to be comparable to a person spending $850 on a Model T in 1909. Notice that there's no one correct answer to the question, what is the value of a 1909 Model T Ford in today's dollars? It depends on if by value you mean how much it cost in terms of a fixed basket of goods, a basket of goods that expanded over time, or how much income you would need to earn and save to buy it. A lot of people are confused by the wide variation in these values, indicating that buying a Model T Ford was the equivalent of buying a small basic car today, all the way up to buying a high-performance luxury car today. If you can focus, though, on the question you're trying to answer, though, you can narrow it down to the value that best answers your question. Also, you should notice that these answers will vary more the further back in time that you go. For example, if you look at the value of a car that you bought just 5 years ago, each of the deflators will give a very similar value. In that case, it doesn't matter as much which deflator you use, because the difference in the growth rates are only compounded over a few years. So that's all for today's video. I hope this has been helpful. Please look out for more videos to come.